You think you know me?
Hello everyone, welcome back to Ratchet Clank 3 Up Your Arsenal. In the last episode we beat the game, and today we're doing some new game plus stuff. And we've gone back to welding in order to do that. So everything seems to be the same, we still got our lightsaber, all of our equipment. But our quick select is empty. Well, do not worry, because you still got all of your weapons and stuff. And I will show you how, I will actually now show how you can easily level up any early game weapon. And I mean early game weapon. Like Nitro Launcher, Infector, even though we got it up to level 4. Technically level 4.5, just by doing the skill point a few episodes back. Then we got the Annihilator, Edges of Doom. Actually, probably I should have this on the front screen. Like up here. So let's get Infector, and Nitro Launcher, Annihilator. Angel of Doom, Spinny Hydra, hell, even Shield Glove, Minotaur Glove, and these weapons probably don't count because they are way late game. Right, we got all of our money, we got all of our experience, however, as you destroy enemies in challenge mode, the bolts they drop are multiplied by the number shown. Destroying more enemies increases this multiplier, but it will reset each time you get hit. I'm not sure if this feature was in the second game. I know if, in fact, it wasn't in the first game. Also, where the hell is my trust back? Also equip charge boots. Right, let's show the easy way to level up weapons in New Game Plus. But first let's go talk to these guys. One of them kills themselves, like that. Yep. You can really easily kill lots of enemies in New Game Plus, right here in welding. And if the weapons are early, they're getting like a chunk of XP. I mean a chunk of XP that they would normally get. So if you wanna get your weapons up to level 5 easily, you can just simply do this. I mean these little guys, you can see the chunk of XP I get. Also we didn't crack 1 million bolt last time, so damn for that. And also the Galactic Rangers are now way less effective. Yeah, they do absolutely jack shit from now on. And they will break it more easily. So if you relied on Galactic Rangers, you can't anymore. Or you can, but it's a bad idea because you can sneeze at them and they die. We've cracked 100 health. And that would be actually the maximum health for the first playthrough. But since we are in second, we can go even further. We can go up to 200 health. But first, we have to go and level up a bunch of these weapons. Stop moving! And of course, more levels you gain, the harder it will be to level up these weapons actually. Let's go like something like Infector. That's a really early weapon. Now here we'll go and actually try to kill that guy, but I don't want that because junk. level up, level up, take you, and then level up you, which levels up this the max. Also, the attacks do no damage when they're infected. Right, let's show off these new weapons. Here's the Infector Bomb. It just splits into five. Nothing there. Nitro Eruptor explodes massively. And that's about it. And here's what I mean about the early, these late weapons not being earlier on. I never noticed that before. Yeah, these late weapons, they don't level up as much. But they still level up a decent amount. But not much. They are way better. You can level up these later weapons much betterly. Or in the later game. Yep. Hello, you make me wanna go that way. I will. So yeah, once you've gotten it to the end, you can just simply kill yourself. You do lose the multiplier, but it doesn't really matter. And you go back to the start. And then you can go and do it all over again. And you don't have to sit through any of the cutscenes. Which is always a bonus. So yeah, if you want, you could just do this over and over until all of your weapons are level 5. But I won't be doing that. I would actually normally probably do this because I just stick to few weapons when I play the game fully. Because I have no reason to use these weapons. Also, a decent amount of health still. Probably because I have no armor. And you stop, bad mistake, you're done. You are done. Get you before you start moving around. Get you. Oh, didn't you know that there's that guy over there? Yeah, he gets destroyed for whatever reason. For whatever reason, that guy just gets destroyed before you come through this area for the first time. Come on, level up. There we go, level 5 Annihilator. Turns into the Decimator, which instead of having the bouncy things, it now has rockets, which do fuck all in terms of damage. Alright, Spinning Hydra. One kill, destroyed them, and leveled up massively. You can just see the amount of XP you can gain. But if you don't want to do this part, the beginning part over and over, you can just go and do this second part, which is just a battle. You can go do that as well if you want. But of course that does mean that we have to free fall. However, if you die, you start on the ground, so you don't have to free fall every single time. And yeah, the dialogue are exactly the same, everything is the same. Unlike Wind Waker, nothing changes when you restart the game in New Game Plus. Nothing changes here. Just keep your stuff. Oh, these guys are tough. Took 3 shots to get rid of you. That took only 2 for whatever reason. Oh no, even more of these guys, they're dead. And here is a good point of Rangers being absolutely useless. Yep, couldn't even destroy one of those guys. There we go, Spinning Hydra, once it levels up, it turns into Tempest. Which does... It still homes, but it does... what is that supposed to be? Cone? Something it kills you. Right, here's the Agent of Glove, which is, well, they run around and kill everyone. Yep, I'm pretty sure they didn't intend this to be the way, but it just is. It is. And yeah, these guys still do a decent amount of damage though, so you might want to remember that. Yeah, the doors are opened. Destroy! Ah, didn't get it almost leveled up. Or all the way leveled up. Oh well. Oh no, there's a big vehicle in my way. Whatever will I do? Well, let's draw the shield, let's get that leveled up. I mean, shield takes forever to level up, so... For whatever reason, this thing is smoking already. I guess shield is considered too endgamey to be easily leveled up. Something on Mitra Glove, that would actually do the job. Are you actually hitting it, or...? Yes, you are. Wow. Oh, that's a first. That's the first time ever I've seen a weapon level up twice. In one sitting. Anyway, if you die, you start right here again, so... Yeah, it's really no biggie. You just do this a whole lot. I don't have any other weapon to level up. Bouncer. Plasma coil, yeah, just to get rid of that guy. So yeah, you can just keep doing this. Get all of your weapons up to level 4, actually level 5. So it's like... This completely eliminates all the challenge. Yeah, yeah, these guys are wasting it, don't worry. Also, the turrets, when they have nothing else to do, they will go and shoot boxes. For whatever reason. And there we go. The Minotaur Glove turns into the Megataur Glove. Which... Well, fires rockets. Homing rockets, to be more precise. And that is, well, pretty much it. Come on, can't you destroy that thing? There we go. Destroy it! There we go. Okay, let's check the weapon situation. No, not the mission, the weapon situation. Max level, max level, max level. All of these are almost max level except these ones. Shield charger is really easy to get up to max level. Yeah, I'll do this one more time, just to get the Edge of Doom. The Edge of Doom clones up to level... Oh, here's the level 4. They become a Guardian! And once they run off energy, they just drop down to the ground. Yeah, but it's nothing interesting, really. Also, they do get distracted easily, so that's a minus. Oi, you assholes. Well, these guys don't level up at all. Better start throwing them onto the ground, maybe that'll actually do something. Also, great AI, this guy doesn't care at all. Whoops. Also, these guys aren't too accurate. And you cannot refill the their ammo. So you actually have to buy the ammo. And that's level 1, they become agents of dread. With the difference when they drop to the ground, they don't get on it like a nuke. And that world is about it. So now we get to do a fun thing, which is just get rid of everything again. And now we got all the bad weapons out the way, so those are the four weapons that I need to level up still. Destroy the vehicle, alright, done. And now we go through this cutscene and, well, I'll see you at Florana. Yeah, we are back in Florana, everything is still the same, however, the interesting thing comes up when I actually go to that, but first, get rid of those. Yeah, for whatever reason, Florana enemies, they just don't level up your weapon at all, pretty much, compared to Belden. Anyway, yeah, we still get the 10% discount from the first game. Yeah, let's buy the ammo. Yep, once again, when you level up your weapons to max, you get the chance to buy mega weapons. Which cost a lot. And then there's the Rhino, which cost 2.7 million. Actually, that cost 3 million this time, so... Yep. It costs a lot, and I'll be honest, the second game had it better. So... Well, we have nothing else to do, we just have to go through the game again. There's literally nothing else to do. So, instead of going through the journey, I am going to see you at Starship Phoenix, because that is literally our next destination, so I'll see you there.
Later.
Here we are back at Starship Phoenix, this time not under attack. Now hold on a sec, I just need to put work there. There we go. And there we go, it actually started working. I went ahead and I bought Meta Liquid Nitrogen Gun. Basically, whenever you buy a mech weapon, it starts at level 6. Level 6. And it goes up to the maximum level, which is 8. Now, the thing I wanted to show is back here. You see all these trophies, the little ones are the ones that we collected. And, yep. We are still missing three big ones that are weapon, health, and skill point. Those are the three trophies we are currently missing. Now the skill point one, I did buy the nitrogen liquid gun. I was hoping to get up to 1 million balls. Let's actually see how much it is 1 million balls. I need 28,000 balls to get that. Back in a sec. And we are back with 1 million bolts. Let's go buy the best armor, which we didn't get to do in the second game, but here we go. The prototype Infernox armor suit. The ultimate achievement in personal protection system. Combines Garmnox alloys imported from Bogon Galaxy, a nanotech control system, and an onboard quantum hellfire generator. Reduces damage by an unbelievable 80%. Buy that. There we go. Skill Master Trophy. And that is it. There we go. kind of a dull looking trophy in the end. Right, before I move on to my main file, I will go and show you. Rhino. Here is pretty much the Rhino Gray. It does that. For the first four levels, when it gets to level 5, the Rhino sucks. Right now it kicks ass. I'm really disappointed on Rhino, because this works incredibly well, gets rid of lots of enemies fast and has good damage. Now let me show you what it actually can do. When we go to, you know, level 5. But first of all, we have to go and buy all the skins. So, Snowman, Tuxedo, Pugnoid, Gloss Casino P2, Brawler, Robo Rooster, Trooper, and Robo. Doesn't do anything. Or you don't get anything for it, but eh, might as well. Great camera work there. Right, let us switch on to my 13th time playthrough. No, actually my 14th playthrough on a single file. We are Stars of Phoenix. This is just before I've done the VR training. And it's a good thing I stopped here, because this lets me show a good feature that the new game plus does. First of all, let us see the rest of the colors that we didn't get to see, which there were maybe two or something. We got to the taxi one, Star Traveler. Then there's Clowner, Playtastic, and Insomniac Special, which is the one I got on my ship, right here. Anyway, there's still three more weapons to show. This is the Plasma Storm, the best weapon. It does that, and everything next to it will die. Here's the Bouncer, slightly bigger version. And that's all. I'm not playing that game, screw that. Right, you know, with comics, they are so different and people may not like it. Well, the first one you have to play, because it is a story mission. But here is the good thing. For episodes 2, 3, 4 and 5, you can skip them. You can skip them completely if you want. So, like that, poof, now I've done it. With best time, being the same, health upgrade, no, and tokens collected, none. You still get the cutscene like you've beaten it, so. Good job, Insomnia. For people who didn't want to play those, go right ahead. And here are the two missing bosses that I didn't get. Right, let's go through all the trophies. There's Ratchet, there's Clank, Captain Quark, Dr. Nefarious, Scrunch, Lawrence, the Plumber, and Cornigius. Of course, we can't forget Al. Right, Titanium Collector you get for collecting all 42 Titanium Balls in the game.
No!
Also, if you do this, you can make the middle bit just pop. So it doesn't rotate at all. Freaky. Or you can go this way and make spin super fast. Then we got the Skill Master for getting all the 30 skill points. We got Nanofinder, which you get once your health reaches 200. Annihilation is a champion for completing all the challenges in Annihilation Nation. Friend of the Rangers you get by helping Rangers in Marcadia, Blackwater City, Aridia, and the two secret ones in Metropolis and Terranosis. And finally, Omega Arsenal you get once all of your weapons reach up to level 8. Except the Rhino. Rhino doesn't go up to level 8. It goes to level 5. Where it becomes Rhino Cyrator. With a massive damage of 10,000. With surprisingly, it's not the highest damaging weapon. Because Omega Agent of Dread beat that. And the Mega Dread Club beats it. So it's not the most powerful weapon. Hi Helga, I'm not doing the VR Simulus, I just wanna show off how bad this weapon is. I mean, it's really useful, however, I just don't like it. Here's what it does. It fires up, big fire, everything in front of you dies. Everything. Drawback, you cannot draw any ammo, you have to buy all of it. Another drawback, if you're not looking at an enemy, they won't die. I really like the rocket launcher more than this. Also, here's Plasma Storm. Again, if you're not looking at an enemy, unless it hits it, it won't kill it. And that's pretty much all the New Game Plus stuff done right there. Now you may be wondering what was behind the door that we couldn't gain access yet. Well, it's just a teleporter to Insomniac Museum that works 24/7. I like the one in Metropolis that only works between 3 a.m. and 4 a.m. This works 24/7. So, fuck off, Quark. So yeah, that does it for this episode. In the final episode of this series, we'll visit Insomniac Museum once again and see all the card stuff from Ratchet and Clank 3.